Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, رَجُلَانِ تَحَابَّ فِي اللَّهِ اِجْتَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ وَتَفَرَّقَ عَلَيْهِ. This applies to the youth and even those post-youth. The hadith says, the categories of seven of the people who will be granted that shade, two of them are those who loved each other for the sake of Allah alone. They gathered for the sake of Allah, they departed also in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We love you not because of your money, not because of your authority, not because of your popularity, simply for the sake of Allah. I may get a chance to tell that to you, I may not get a chance to tell that to you. So how is love for the sake of Allah? Let me tell you. When you hear someone saying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there should already be one level of love between you and them. There should be. That is love for the sake of Allah. Why? This person shares the Shahada that I have. The minute you feel the hatred in that, there is something wrong with your own Shahada. That is what it is. There is something wrong with your own Shahada. How can you hate others who utter La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Even if they're making a mistake, you dislike their mistake, you dislike their error, but you don't dislike the person, you love them. Then you see someone coming into the masjid. What are they trying to achieve? They are trying to get closer to the same Allah you are trying to get close to. So we are all going in the same direction. When the World Cup was here in Cape Town, people started giving each other lifts to go to the venue because they didn't want a massing of vehicles there. So they were all heading for the same match. So we decided to create a lift club. You know what I'm talking about. So in the same way, we're all heading to Jannah. Let's create a lift club. I help you, you help me. I love you, you love me. MashaAllah, I see you in the masjid, I'm so happy. MashaAllah, you're reading salah. It doesn't mean that this uncle is taking so long in sujood, so he's a big show off. No, he is worshipping Allah. You need to love him for that. SubhanAllah, a sister who's trying to wear her hijab and you see her on the street, it doesn't mean you have to greet her and you have to make yourself known as a young man. Hey, you know what? I'm available, by the way. That's not how it should be. No. You need to make dua for her without her knowing that you've made dua. Your heart needs to feel this connection for the sake of Allah. That's my sister. If you see any harm in her direction, or if there is an opportunity to render any form of assistance for her, you should be the first one before anyone else, because you have a deep connection and she's trying very hard to dress appropriately at a time when it is not easy to dress so appropriately due to the Islamophobia across the entire globe. So shouldn't it be a means of your happiness? You smile. MashaAllah, look at the sister, look at the brother. MashaAllah, they are trying so hard. You see people reading the Quran, you see someone giving a charity. Think good things about one another. Someone gives a charity, don't say he's just boasting because he's got a lot of money. Those are negative thoughts. They are not heavenly, they are not divinely inspired thoughts. They are thoughts that are actually coming and stemming from the evil of the devil and the evil of our own selves. So let's protect ourselves from this. This is why the hadith says, if you really love one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and obedience brings you together, you deserve VIP status. Subhanallah.